We can think of it like a worm that gets into the horse and causes neurologic damage. It is prevalent in the equine industry, but it's very regionally specific or regionally prevalent. And so down here in Texas, yes, we have a lot of it.
What's is it from possums, or what actually is it from? Do you know?
So the possum is actually the carrier of it, and that is what spreads it to the horse.
Right.
It's through the possum's feces. Again, you can think of it as like a worm. So it's spread through their feces. And the unfortunate thing is that, especially down here, to test proprioception, we oftentimes will ask them to maneuver their hind end around in a circle and see how they place their feet. Are they going to cross over, which is what most horses will do, or are they going to step on themselves or catch their hind feet and almost trip over their legs? So we'll see how this mare does this. So you can see she's actually placing her hind foot over top of the other one. There she's not. Over top. And she's not tripping over herself. And then we're going to stop and see where she places her feet. They should always square up at the end of that. Some horses will stop with their legs crossed or almost have two front legs positioned right next to each other and the hind wide. She actually squared up those front legs, if you saw. And we do it both directions. In EPM, typically one side is more affected than the other. So this side she has a little bit harder time. There she stepped on herself. And she's not fully off. Okay, so we're really evaluating her strength to this tail pole. And then we'll do it the opposite direction. And again, typically, we look at a lot of other things as well. So we look at their hair coat, you know, and we obviously gauge that dependent upon the time of year that it is. But, you know, are all the horses in the barn, do they have a slick and nice hair coat versus this horse has a long, dull hair coat? It really affects them overall as far as their health goes. So we look at that. And we also look at muscle mass. Again, we're affecting nervous system, and so that has to do with the innervation to those muscles. And we'll assess the top line, their hips. Sometimes you'll get atrophy or loss of muscle on one side versus the other. I think one of the biggest things is also looking at that masseter muscle. This muscle is one that all horses use when they're eating. And so really every horse should have a well-developed masseter muscle or muscle over their jaw from them eating. And some horses that have really bad EPM, this will be very